It's morning. Dagwood awakens, stretches, and sits back on the edge of his bed. And he says,
"Oh boy, am I sleepy. This is one of those mornings I just can't wake up."
And he crawls back into bed. When Blondie comes in, Dagwood looks as if he were dying and moans,
"Oh, call up the office. Tell them I won't be in today. I have every ache and pain known to medical science."
So Blondie goes out of the room. And last picture top row, Dagwood shakes the paw of Daisy, his dog, and says with a smile,
"Congratulate me, it worked. I tried that gag 100 times. This is the first time she ever fell for it."
The children come in, and Alexander says,
"Hey, we're sorry you're not well, Daddy."
Dagwood moans,
"Oh, Papa's a sick and ailing man."
Alexander says,
"Hey, Mr. Woodley's downstairs and wants to see you, Daddy."
"Oh, tell him I'm too sick to see anyone."
Herb Woodley starts up the stairs. Blondie grabs him and says,
"Don't you dare to go up there. Dagwood's a sick man."
Dagwood hears a noise outside his window. And a second later, Herb has climbed up the ladder, stuck his head in the window, and is saying,
"You idiot, this isn't a work day. This is Sunday. You have a date to go fishing with us."
Dagwood's eyes pop open. He exclaims,
"Oh, my goodness."
And then as Herb climbs down the ladder to go fishing, Dagwood chews his fingernails, saying,
"Oh, how could I have made a terrible mistake like that? Oh, what can I do?"
Dagwood comes downstairs with his clothes on, and he tells Blondie and the children,
"Hey, look, I'm well. That little bitty pill I took cured me."
And then he dashes out of the house and leaps into his car. First picture bottom row, Dagwood has arrived at the lake where his friends are fishing. They're not making a sound, so the fish won't be scared away. Dagwood jumps out of his car and yells,
"Look, boys, it's me! I'm here!"
His friends leap on him and start to beat him up.
"Hey, quiet! Yip-a! Quiet!
Yip-a!
Quiet!
Yip-a!"
Dagwood lies on the ground unconscious from a conk on the head. His three friends go back to their fishing, and one asks,
"Hey, do you think we were too rough on him?"
And Herb replies,
"If we can't have him scaring the fish away."
Well, that was no way for Herb to treat Dagwood when he was so happy.
No. He was being a little rough. Instead of hitting him on the head, they should have put a sponge in his mouth.
What good would that do?
Oh, when Dagwood tried to talk, the sponge would soak up the words.
You're just as funny as the funny.